Well, trust is a pretty tricky game for a traitor, and while Marielle played a bold game, she too learned that you can never really trust anyone.
Do we save face and fight Marielle? I mean, I don't want to, obviously.
I don't.
Marielle, that's why I've written your name down. I'm sorry.
I am a bartender, but I'm also in my seventh year of law and international relations at university, and I'm a professional Ironman triathlete. I kept this stuff secret because from day one, I was absolutely terrified that the traitors would use it against me and have a reason to get rid of me. But it didn't matter because I was a traitor from day one.
There she goes. And Marielle was banished, but she joins us now live from Adelaide. Marielle, it's great to speak to you. How blindsided were you by the banishment room last night?
Completely. I did not see it coming. I went in there feeling pretty good and they got me good. I was totally blindsided.
Marielle, you played the most Machiavellian game, let's be honest. You were plotting and planning right from the beginning, including going after your fellow traitors. So why did you decide to do that? Didn't you suspect that at some stage it could come back to bite you on the bot?
Yeah, look, absolutely. Going for my fellow traders was always a really risky option, but I think the people that I was friends with in the game and that I was so close to were looking really hard at Claire and Angus. And so in a bit of self-preservation and a bit of a hostile takeover, I decided just to go with that and unfortunately to take them out.
Yeah, unfortunately, yeah. But last night we saw Alex, who's the new traitor recruit, put on the Waterworks with Feeds murder. What did you make of that?
Look, I was like a proud mum watching Alex bring up the tears. I was like a proud traitor mum. She's doing it. She played it off perfectly. I mean, I think we were all quite sad to see Fee go, and Alex just leaned into that and she did an amazing job. It was a flawless performance.
How do you cry on cue? That's what I want to know.
I know, right? It's hard.
All right, so Alex ended up coming for you in the banishment room. What did you make of that move?
They say imitation is the sincerest form of flattery, and Alex just completely played my own game against me. I was very shocked. I didn't think that she would do that, but I had played exactly the same game, and if I was in Alex's shoes, that's probably exactly what I would have done.
So you're impressed as well?
Yeah.
I was very impressed. I was sad, but I was impressed.
But fellow trader Nigel stayed true to your pact. I'm curious to know, did you have plans to knife him down the track, or would you have taken him to the end?
I was never going to go against Nigel. I would have been absolutely stoked to stand at the end with him. And of all the lies I told on the show, I was always honest with Nigel, and I would have loved to stand at the end with him. I was never going to go against him. No.
Did Nigel ever tell you the truth about his background behind the scenes on the show, him being a hostage negotiator and a hostage survivor?
No. He didn't reveal it to me at any point that I was on the show. I had absolutely no idea.
Wow. When you got out and you did your research, were you like, I can't believe it?
Oh, my gosh. I was just so in awe and surprised, and I wish I'd had a chance to talk to him about it, because it's just an amazing story. But no, he kept it locked down. He played a pretty secretive game, Nigel.
Oh, well, who
his audiobook
will be banished next? You can tune into The Traitors Sunday to Tuesday nights at 7:30 on 10 and Template on Demand. Marielle, thanks so much for coming in to chat today.
Thanks, guys. Good to speak to you.
Bye.
Take care.